I'm Trina Morris. I'm a wildlife biologist with the Georgia Department of Natural Resources Wildlife Conservation Section. Today, I'm going to teach you how to participate in our bat roost monitoring project. The first thing you need is a bat roost, and today we're here in my garden where we have a bat house. This is one of the many types of bat roost you can count, but it's one that we can build for bats. You can find out more information about how to put up your own bat roost at georgiawildlife.com and search for bat houses. The most important thing about counting bats coming out of your roost is finding a good place to count and a good time to count them. You need to count right around sunset, and you need to find a place where you can see the sky behind the house so you can easily count bats as they emerge. We have an easy program you can use on your smartphone or tablet, and we'll show you how to do that as soon as it starts to get dark. So when you're getting ready to do your bat count, you need to get a chair or a nice area where you can stand that you can see your bat house. And then you want to have all your resources ready. I would recommend if you have a larger bat colony that you have someone else write down numbers for you, or you write down numbers for someone else so it's easier to count and keep track. Or you can use one of those little hand clickers if you have one of those and you actually have a lot of bats. But you need to first go to our website, and that's at georgiawildlife.com. You can go to georgiawildlife.com and search bat roost monitoring, and you'll get to our webpage. And you need to read through the instructions and look at the information before you actually start your count. And I'm going to open up the data sheet to show you what that looks like. So if you don't want to use a smartphone or tablet, you don't have to. You can print out a data form and use that. But if you want to use a smartphone or a tablet, you can open up this app and fill out all the information associated with your survey. Again, after you read the instructions so you know how to do it, and then you can wait for your bats and count them and then submit your data. We ask you to do it twice a year during two different periods in the summertime so that you can count bats before and after they have pups. So after you get all of your stuff ready and have your app out in front of you, the last thing to do is just wait for sunset and for your bats to come out. Generally, they will come out just a little bit after regular sunset. It will still feel bright outside, but if you look at sunset time, you can have a good idea of when they'll come out. And I suggest watching it a few nights before you actually count. You want good weather, and you can read all about what you need to do before you count bats on our website. But for now, we're just gonna sit in a good spot and wait for the bats to come out. So we're done with our count. It didn't take very long at all. I hope you were able to see all those bats on the video, and I hope you learned how to count bats at your bat roost. You can visit georgiawildlife.com to find out more information about bats by searching Bats of Georgia, or more information about this program by searching Bat Roost Monitoring. Thanks for watching.